If you're looking for one of the simplest ways you can get started streaming on Twitch from either a Mac or a PC, then stick around. I'm JZimz, and in this video, I'll show you how you can use Twitch Studio to get started streaming on Twitch with minimal configuration and in only a few minutes. Before we get started though, don't forget to like and subscribe if you find this video helpful. And I also stream on Twitch weekly, so you can stop by anytime and we can talk more about this video. Alright, so Twitch recently released an app called Twitch Studio. It's free to use, has everything you need to get started, and works on both Macs and PCs. It even includes support for stream alerts right inside the app. I'm really excited about this because Macs are typically overlooked when it comes to streaming software. Head over to twitch.tv/broadcast/studio to download it and get started. They've really made the process of getting started streaming very easy by simplifying the whole setup into a 4-step wizard process. Just select the mic you'd like to use for streaming, and choose any additional audio features you'd like to add. I personally like the noise suppressor to keep any of the extra noises happening in the room from distracting my viewers. Next, choose the webcam you'd like to use for your stream. They've also included a lot of cool predefined filters, so flip through them and see which one makes you look best. Next, set up your layouts. Each layout is used for different segments of your stream, whether you're gaming, taking a break, or just chatting with your viewers. The predefined ones they give you are actually a great start, but feel free to add more if you like later. Also, check out the customized layouts if you'd like to tweak any of the colors or personalize it to your own taste. The final and probably the most helpful step in this process is the stream quality settings. Streaming requires a lot from your computer in order to convert your video into a format suitable for streaming. On top of this, a solid internet connection is required in order to then upload it to Twitch. The great part about Twitch Studio is that it automatically checks the capabilities of both your computer and internet connection in order to determine the best settings for your stream. This is a huge time saver considering there are several videos out there dedicated to discussing how to choose the right settings. My only tips here are to only tweak these settings if you know what you're doing, and also connect your computer to your network using an Ethernet cable if at all possible. And with that, you're pretty much ready to hit the start streaming button and go live. You can click here to set the title of your stream. And I also love that chat is built right into the app, so pay attention here and try your best to interact with your viewers. If you're interested in more though, here are a few additional things I'd like to mention about the app. By default, the main layout will show whatever application you have in full screen mode. You can change that by editing the layout, going to Game Capture, and changing the application it's broadcasting. Also, if you're using a capture card to stream from a console, you'll need to delete the game capture layer and add a new webcam layer where you choose your capture card as the input. Make sure your game capture is below your webcam. And finally, you have an option to record a local copy of your stream to your computer. This is great for editing clips later after the stream, but make sure you record to a secondary hard drive. You can change the location of your recording by clicking on Settings, going to the Recording tab, and selecting a directory on your secondary hard drive. And that's all it takes to get started streaming to Twitch using the new Twitch Studio app. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you found this video helpful. And I'm also streaming on Twitch weekly if you'd like to drop by and chat about this a little bit more. All the links you need can be found in the description below. Thanks for watching.